Formula One. The adrenaline-fueled extravaganza with the top drivers in the world going wheel to wheel for the championship. With 24 races in the 2024 season, teams will be facing more challenges than ever before. We're ready for excitement ahead as the teams return to the drawing board in the battle to end Red Bull's dominance. They'll need to balance their aspirations for high performance with the risk of pushing too far and inviting catastrophic failures out on the track. With many drivers on the last year of their contracts, team principals will need to ensure that they're kept in the right mindset across the whole season, as well as managing sponsor demands and protecting their most valuable assets from the prying eyes of their rivals. The competition is fiercer than ever. This is Formula One. Alpine are entering the 2024 season determined to reverse their recent decline and strive to stay competitive in the midfield. With the Gallic driver duo of Esteban Ocon and Pierre Gasly returning for another season, Alpine are well placed to put down a marker this year.
Thank you.
A very warm welcome to you all. It sure does feel good to be back. Every team and driver comes here with the same goal, to win. But that's for the end of the season. For now, they have to prepare to fight for F1 glory.
The teams will be utilizing the data they gathered from the pre-season testing here in Bahrain, hoping that they've got everything they need to make a strong start.
Our weekend action starts here.
Track is green. How's the balance, please?
All okay, yeah.
Copy that. How's the balance?
I'm really pleased.
Copy that. Okay, Saban, balance update when you can. Balance update.
The balance is really good.
Okay, copy that. Okay, and that is the checkered flag. Phase updates when you can. Phase updates when you can.
That tower's gone.
Copy that. Light.
There's a yellow flag now.
Oh, I made another mistake.
Let's hope the teams took full advantage of practice. It's time for qualifying.
The session will be divided into Q1, Q2 and Q3. With the slowest five drivers eliminated from each period, their best times will determine the grid for the upcoming race.
Now there's a driver we've been talking about quite a bit. Karu, how will they be feeling today?
The main thing on my mind was their speed in practice. They just weren't that fast. But was that down to the driver, the car, the team experimenting? We don't know, and we'll just have to see how they fare in qualifying.
Hold on tight, because we're getting underway. Here in Sakhir, the floodlights are on, and it's nearly time for 57 laps around the Bahrain International Circuit.
Bahrain has seen some of the most dramatic races in F1, like Sergio Perez's incredible 2020 victory, surging ahead from being last on the opening lap.
The Bahrain International Circuit is a challenging track, and the cars routinely have to brake from high gear to low to take the narrow turns. With the need for downhill braking, the risk of locking up is one drivers will need to manage. It's all about focus and balance to get victory here. The time has come to fight it out. It's race day. Well then, it's not long until we get started here, and we should be in for a tightly contested race. Yuki Tsunoda will be hoping things go his way today.
Ninth is a fairly good grid position. If they make the right calls, they could well score some points.
This should certainly be a good one, folks. And this is it. The Bahrain Grand Prix. And it's lights out, and away we go.
off these tyres just a little bit.
Copy that. DRS enabled. 8 currently. Bottas is the car in front.
Gap point 3.
Sargeant behind.
Gap point 2.
Stop your car.
Still a long way to go.
So this is what happened. Right, let's have a look as we go into turn 4. And the car fails to respond. By that point, it was just too late.
Thank you.
we should be able to take a look here. Here we are, down at turn 7. Just a bit too wide at that point. That won't do the floor of the car any good at all.
Are we on tire temp?
Do with bringing them down slightly if we can. Okay, Sven, lift and coast is required for temperature.
Copy. Copy now.
Has DRS. Time management was looking very good before.
Yeah, copy that.
As DRS.
Okay, understood.
Has DRS. Behind the SDRS.
Okay.
How do the tyres feel?
Tyre feel still good.
Has DRS.
has DRS.
Copy that, yeah.
Just like a sitting duck, like that.
Keep your head down.
So the car behind is Magnussen.
We're P14. Albon in front. Gap 3.1 now. We've got Hülkenberg behind. Okay, gap 1 second. Hülkenberg has DRS behind. Thank you. just in DRS range behind. Hülkenberg has DRS this time. All to play for. Car behind Sargeant. Gap 2.1.
Take available.
Copy.
How are the tires?
I'm feeling good on the tires.
Not give up. So we have Sergeant behind him. Gap 1.9. We're looking pretty good, actually.
I can't do anything, guys.
Everything you've got, please, mate. Come on. Hülkenberg has DRS. What? Hülkenberg has DRS.
Yeah, copy that.
Tire update, please.
Struggling a bit with the rear. Guys, I can't do anything.
Come on, mate, let's keep on it. He came out behind us. Gap behind 2.2 seconds.
Happy to pick up the pace.
Copy.
Has boxed.
Copy.
How are the tires?
Yes, lift. Yes.
Does have DRS. vulnerable. Box in this lap.
Box, box, box.
Okay, well managed.
Yeah, in the box.
Let's push.
Copy.
Okay, so man, box this lap, please. Box, box.
Step on in.
So that is P18. Albon, the car ahead. Bottas is the car behind. Gap is 1.6 seconds.
Yeah, I lost it in 8.
I'm okay.
Okay.
What the f***?
Just focus on tire management.
Copy.
It looks like a pit stop issue.
P15. Okay, so we've got Albon in front. Bottas now the car behind.
Bottas 1.6 behind now. 38 laps to go. Overtake is available.
Yeah.
Yeah.
We are P15. Albon in front. Bottas is the car behind. Gap behind 1.2.
Temperatures look pretty good.
Copy.
Has DRS.
Copy.
So we're in P17. Car ahead is Bottas. Gap is 4.9. Sergeant behind, 1.5. He has DRS.
I'm just all over the place.
Still a long way to go. Car behind is now Magnussen.
It's all good, it's all good. Sergeant behind. DRS.
has DRS.
Keep it up. We have Sergeant behind. Gap behind 3.2. DRS.
Yeah, copy that.
Very happy with management so far, keep it up.
Copy that.
He has DRS. Point 0.8 behind the SDRS. Overtake available.
Copy that.
Phase update when you can, please.
I feel it's still good.
Thank you. So we've got Albon in front.
Gap 1.9.
Come on, let's focus. Currently, Albon in front. So gap to Albon, 2.2 seconds. Bottas the car behind. Gap 6 seconds. Okay, buddy, no worries. Let's go right down.
Okay, Pierre, we're happy to reduce management.
keep us informed on the tyre.
Dragging a bit with the rear.
Gap 1.4. You got this, come on. Gap 1.2 seconds. Keep your head in the game. Ward just leaving the pit lane now. Okay, gap 1 second. Let's keep going, we're in a good place.
Something's not gone right in the pits.
Still all to play for. Play for. Yeah. monitoring again looks very good.
Copy that.
Box.
Okay, box. See that?
All right, sorry about that.
Now down to the pits. There's been a hold up.
Box, Pierre, box.
Box, box.
Eight currently. Hulkenberg in front. Car behind Sergeant. Laps remaining. He'll get blue flags for you. He has DRS.
So that is P18. Bottas ahead. He is 10 seconds up the road. Magnussen behind.
And what's that? A pit stop issue.
Blue flag.
Flags for you. DRS. You've got Bottas behind. Gap 0.8 behind. An awful lot can happen here. Bottas now the car behind. Bottas 1.8 seconds behind now. Let's stick with him, come on.
Tires look good from our side. Car in front is Bottas. He's 8 seconds up the road. Next car back is now Joe. There's a car off.
Yellow flag.
Copy. A huge amount of understeer at low speed.
Car in front, Sergeant. Gap 1.2 seconds.
back for us. Sergeant in front. Gap 1.6. Let's give it our all. Sergeant, is the car in front? Okay, mate, let's stick with it. Long way to go. Okay, let's keep on it. Overtake button available.
Copy that.
Gap 0.6. Hit your full, it's all good. So we've got Albon in front. Gap 1.9. Let's keep going.
happy with management.
Copy, copy.
Let's pick our pace up, let's go. Albon in front. No, it's tricky, doing a good job. Let's keep it up. This management is very good. Play for still. Keepers updated on how those tyres feel.
Tyre feel is still good.
How are the tires?
I'm good with the tire.
Thank you.
focus on those temps.
Okay.
He'll get blue flags for you. Okay, so let's keep going. P15.
Okay, cap point 4. Sergeant behind. Gap behind 5.7.
Signs off in the runoff area.
Now this happens down at turn 8. Whoa, and there it goes. And I wonder, could they have done anything about that?
Hulkenberg in front.
Gap 1.2 seconds.
Let's keep going.
6 laps to go.
Copy that.
They're doing a good job. No more lift and coast required.
Copy.
Gap 0.2.
All right, let's keep it up.
5 laps to go. Hülkenberg has DRS behind. Hülkenberg has DRS this time.
He does have DRS.
To go at the end of this one. Okay, man. Everything you've got. Let's push.
I can't do anything, guys.
Okay, mate. So head down. Car behind is Albon. Gap behind 3.3.
So we need to try and push, mate.
Copy.
Great job. Currently running P13.
Tsunoda in front.
Watch for fuel. Okay, we need lift and coast, please.
Save fuel.
Copy.
So suggest increasing lift and coast.
Copy.
3 laps to go.
No lift and coast required from our side at the moment.
2 laps remaining.
You can reduce lift and coast if desired.
Yeah.
Max Verstappen over the finish line and today's winner.
Big lift into 14. Okay, mate, so overtake isn't available at the moment.
Okay, that's the checkered flag.
So that's P13.
We did alright then.
Keep believing. Thank you very much, everyone.
Okay, so it'll be normal switch off procedures, please. So come to a stop for 4 or 5 seconds, then go to P1, and then another 5 second pause at P0, please.
And that is the checkered flag. P17. We'll regroup and we'll go again.
Yeah, I think overall, very, very tough race. Very, very good job all weekend.
Once you're stopped, you can switch the car off so we can go to P0.
Now, after the excitement of that race, we can now see Esteban Ocon.
And with a 13th place finish, that sadly means there's no points to be claimed.
A podium finish for the Red Bull driver, putting in a huge amount of effort to get the team up there.
And that's win number one of the season, and it's sure to provide them with a real confidence boost.
And we've certainly kicked things off in style, here at the Bahrain Grand Prix. So after that race, Karun, how do you think the mood will be among the Alpine team?
Well, it was a bit of a mixed bag here. Some things went their way, but others didn't. I think their main target now will be finding some consistency for sure.
And that is about that for this weekend's action here in Bahrain.
In the next round, we head to the shores of the Red Sea as Formula One returns to Jeddah for the Saudi Arabian Grand Prix.